Hello everyone, today I'm going to tell you something about love. What is love? I'll be telling you a short story. A soldier was finally coming home after having fought in Vietnam. He called his parents from San Francisco. Mom and Dad, I'm coming home, but I have a favor to ask. I have a friend I'd like to bring home with me. Sure, they replied. We'd love to meet him. There's something you should know, the son continued. He was hurt pretty badly in the war. He stepped on a landmine and lost an arm and a leg. He has nowhere else to go, and I want him to come and live with us. I'm sorry to hear that, son. Maybe we can help him find somewhere to live. No, Mom and Dad, I want him to live with us, son said the father. You don't know what you are asking. Someone with such a handicap would be a terrible burden on us. We have our own lives to live, and we can't let something like this interfere with our lives. I think you should just come home and forget about this guy. Shortly thereafter, the son hung up the phone. The parents heard nothing more from him. A few days later, however, they received a call from the San Francisco police. Their son had died after falling from a building. They were told. The police believed it was suicide. The grief-stricken parents flew to San Francisco and were taken to the city morgue to identify the body of their son. They recognized him, but to their horror, they also discovered something they didn't know. Their son had only one arm and one leg. So, true love can only be unbounded, unconditional, and all-encompassing. We just can't love one and hate the other. Love women and hate the men. Love plants and hate the animals. Love day and hate the night. Love later and hate the now. That's not what pure love is. That's love with a few drops of poison. That's not the love you are ever longing for. When you truly fall in love, you fall in love with yourself and with the whole of existence without a trifling exception. You fall in love with God, the eternal, the ever-present, and the ever-blissful. Love then shall never be a burden. You begin to grow and expand only when your concern for others outweighs the concern for yourself. That's when you sprout and blossom and experience the eternal. So that brings happiness all around.